Good morning, students. Right? What we are doing? We are doing here chapter number 2 in history, writing and city life. Right? So what we are doing is over here. So first of all, write the differences between very long question, city life and rural life. You know what is a city life, right? So city life, when we are talking over here, it is also known as urban, and this is rural is also called village, right? So what I wanted to tell you, now you compare with your grandparents, your parents and yourself, the life has become very much faster and complicated, right? And we are going with the digital world. But before 50 years, it was not like that. So this is a very, very important question of 8 marks, which will definitely will come. So you need to write 8 points, 100 words in your own, or you can write with the paragraph. So I have given you some of the definitions like over here. Now here, life is very, very busy, right? In the city, you are doing one job, then you may go for another job, you may go for walking, right, and other things over here. And in the rural area, you are basically mainly involved in the agricultural farming, right? So maybe related with the agricultural products, not maybe related with the cattle feeding and other things are also involved over here. Then when we talk about the second one, right, in the city life, as I told you, more people are doing migration to come to the city because of the advanced system of the educations as well as medical and other things. So here the second point we say is over here, we have more vehicles, right? Since we have more vehicles, definitely there will be diseases will be more over here. So we have number of hospitals also more, traffic is also more. When we talk of the natural vegetations and talking of the village, okay, it is a very less pollution free, and definitely we generally take care of our cows, buffaloes, whatever the husbandry animals are belonging, we do take care, and you get an open vegetation where health is our totally good, and we do lot of physical activities, right? Here in city we may go for the gym and other things, and but we may be left out. Now third point I want to tell you about the more pollution. Definitely, as you mentioned, right, when the more vehicles are there, definitely the pollutions will be more, and which makes lot of problems. So from the car, from the buses, from the trucks, you are getting lot of type of smoke, black smoke, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide. So these are the, and when we burn the garbages, right, we are getting methane gas as well as other gases are coming up. So definitely in the village area, vehicles are less and less population. When we going with the fourth point, expensive, right? Staying life is very, very expensive. If you are staying in the rent house and other, it is very, very expensive. And you have to pay taxes for a lot of things, right? House taxes will be there, water tax will be there. So just I mentioned over here, we may go to the restaurants, we may go to somewhere or visiting someone, friends, and we take something to. So definitely things are expenses over here. But when we compare with the village, right, it is little cheaper, or maybe cheaper, and you are getting the things in the pure formation, right? When we are talking of the city life, again, no socialization, right? Mostly 80% are busy with their family, husband, wife are working, children are going to the school. So we don't bother what is happening in the next. We generally don't know. Maybe in the meeting we may meet somewhere, then only we are going to, on the occasions we are knowing it. But when we talking of the rural area, definitely there will be helping. If anything happens, all the village people will crowd together, they will come combined and will help in any type of issue. Okay? Then we go with the sixth point. It is related to the financial and other things. We do have, when we see in the rural area, we have self-sufficiency related to the electronic items, related to the automobiles and everything. We are well planned and well settled. And we may have some financial problem in the rural area, but we may get a loan from the banks to solve the problems. Like when we are in agriculture, we need some tractors and other things over here. we see here that nuclear family means when the husband, wife and the children are staying, right? So that is nuclear family. And generally when we talk of the rural area, that we have a joint family, that means your father, mother, their relations are staying, grandbrothers are staying. At the same way, you may also find out some other advantages and disadvantages. Both are available in both the sides. Then when we talk of the last points over here, right, we are living in the cities, we are staying in the apartments, right, or maybe in the colony with the well reserved and well systems of all the things, right, especially the Seagull line and all the things are well planned. And when we are talking of the hut, right, especially in the rural area, big houses are there, but it may be one story over here. So at the last, what I want to tell you, this is a very, very important chapter. You must able to find it out more differences among yourself. As you know, today is a 11th July, World Population Day. You must know what are the countries when we are talking of, you know, China is number one in the population state and number two India, followed by America. Now I wanted to ask you two questions. Which state in India having the highest population? And second one, densely populated state. So when you should have a globe, and in the check in the globe, you must try to find it out. Okay, which are the top 10 countries which are populated or having more populations? So kindly find it out. Till I come, you find and do the things. Till that time, take care of your thing. Thank you very much.